The chair of the House Ways and Means Committee, Albay 2nd District Representative Joey Salceda, is pushing for a two-week extension of the Luzon lockdown. Congressman Salceda warns lifting the lockdown by the end of April could worsen the coronavirus crisis and deal an even bigger impact on the Philippine economy. Congressman Salceda now joins us on the program. Magandang hapon, Congressman Joey.
Yeah, magandang hapon.
So, as of today, what is your view on the impact of the enhanced community quarantine on the economy, and how much more will it suffer if the quarantine is extended for another 2 weeks?
Ang tingin ko, mga sa ngayon po, mga nasa negative 2.8 to negative 1% po ang magiging GDP forecast, and masasabi na na halos kung ang base po ay zero, lahat po nung negative galing po sa ECG, at pero babawi na lang po tayo siguro next year. Mm-hmm. Gawa, kailangan po talaga natin ang sacrificeon to para po mas malaki po ang magiging negative kung hindi natin pinatupad yung ECQ. Gawa nga po, mas mawawalan po ng consumer ang kumpiyansa sa ating sistema. At tingin ko naman, if you cannot control COVID, then I think the economy will be in a far worse situation.
Mm. And right now, you know, people are already talking about how the Philippine economy can recover once this lockdown period ends. And what is your view on how we can actually jumpstart the economy after this crisis?
I just came actually from economic stimulus cluster of the House. Mm-hmm. I just slept and because of malis pumunta po ako doon.
Yeah.
At very vigorous and very robust naman po ang pag-usap. At nag-report po si Secretary Sani na halos 8% of GDP na ang naibigay pong suporta ng gobyerno na umabot po sa 1.491 trillion. This came from us from only 1.1 trillion. So ibig sabihin, we are applying both fiscal and monetary policy so that we can prevent provide safety nets, especially most vulnerable, as well as of course give support to aggregate demand. And eventually I think next year, I think we have the tools in order to pursue more policies or that will essentially allow a recovery in our growth. In simple, I think the House stimulus package, as well as of course what is being discussed in the IATF, as well as among economic managers, is really supporting the MSME, mm-hmm. as well as of course providing some support to our tourism and travel. Of course, boosting of course aggregate demand by providing payroll protection, especially to dun po sa ating pong mga SMEs na sana hindi sila magtanggal ng trabador. At the same time po, providing with fiscal measures like an expanded enhanced NOCO. Pero ang pinopropose nga po namin, and this will cost about 140 billion, one of the bigger components is na basta po nakabase po sa kanilang retention of workers.
Mm-hmm. All this talk about getting loans and getting grants to actually help the economy recover, in your view, yes. Is that going to be less of a burden for the economy that we actually enter into more debt?
First, our debt to GDP is only 41. That is suboptimal. Actually, we can increase it, but we were going for A rating. And our forex debt to GDP is 23%, I think the lowest in Asia. We have sufficient reserves of 83 billion. So if we go back to a growth mode, then we have the dollars to pay for imports.
Yeah.
And of course, our BSP has been pretty supportive. They've actually released about 843 billion in monetary stimulus into our system, and that could in effect I think produce about incremental gains for our SMEs as well as other enterprises of about sabi nila estimate nila kanina 360 billion.
Mm-hmm.
So kaya po na, we have the resources as well as we have the tools.
Yeah. And, you know, some reports earlier saying that the president's economic team was mulling over the imposition maybe of new taxes or additional taxes that would actually, you know, boost revenues to help the government spend for economic recovery measures. What is your outlook on that?
I think we will do it for the next admin, but I think the execution or the implementation will be deferred.
The next admin.
Most of the revenue measures.
You're talking about it for them. You're talking about 2022.
That's right. Before 2022, because most of the 600 billion additional tax measures are already pending in the Senate.
Hmm.
So it's actually up to the predisposition of the Senate whether we will have the political will and probably not encumber, because much of what we're using right now, for example, among Asian nations, we probably were first to get about $6 billion from ADB World Bank so that we would have the financing for a possible return to growth in 2021. So I think... Pero siyempre, babayaran natin yung kahit po concessional, mga 15-year loan yun, concessional rate. But at the same time, I think we continue to practice fiscal prudence even as we, for the next, for sa susunod po na admin. But in the meantime, I think we must support aggregate demand by investing in what we would have invested anyway, like health, so like education, like health goods production. So I think this could be an enhanced infrastructure program or enhanced BBB that is most critical really to the return to growth of the Philippines.
So you believe the government can actually continue many of its infrastructure programs, even though it's already been spending a lot at this point to help alleviate the plight of people impacted by this lockdown?
Yes, sir, because some of them are really ODA and they don't come in the form of giving us money and then we buy.
Mm-hmm.
It's really just, you know, transfer of goods like railways, like subways, like rolling stocks. And so I think that basically boosts the productivity as well as, of course, the aggregate output. So ito pong mga build natin ngayon, halos po nasa, I would say, about 85% are actually bilateral ODA loans. So this actually create also demand for their home country like Japan or China, because they need to boost aggregate demand as well, and therefore one of the sources of aggregate demand for them is external demand, and therefore it is in their best interest really to roll out. And in our interest, we need this productivity enhancing infrastructure so that our economy will yung atipong mga enterprises will have lower cost of doing business. Thank you.